Today I would like to talk to you about the power of the Holy Eucharist. You know, like 2 days ago I went to church. I was a bit tired, you know, like a bit sad, and I was entering the church, you know, just listening to the priest. A lot of spiritual fights going on in my mind. And then came the moment when I went to the Holy Eucharist, you know. I went to the Eucharist, partake to the Holy Eucharist. Went back to my seat, and suddenly I felt this overflow of peace and overflow of peace and joy in my heart. It was an amazing, amazing encounter with Christ, you know. We all search for this wonder pill to happiness and to joy, you know. And we got this wonder pill of happiness and joy. This pill you can get in the Eucharist, you know. It's God who makes himself to little white bread. Look at the humility of God. And he's giving it to us as a spiritual manna, as like the Jewish people had when they were walking 40 years through the desert. You know, and when we walk through the desert of our life, like I did, you know, I was a bit like sad and you know, not in peace. And I took the spiritual manna and suddenly had this deep peace and deep joy in my heart. You see that power of the Eucharist? Please tell it to other people, you know, that they come back to church, you know. You can have it daily. It's for free, you know. Hallelujah, it's for free. That's why we're called Hallelujah people, you know, it's for free, you know. That's what the Catholic Church is about. It's not about money. It's not about, you know, you have to do something. You can go there. You can receive for free the Holy Eucharist. And you can have this peace and joy in your mind, you know. Important is that you are prepared for it. That means like you're in a state of grace, that you had a good confession before, you know, that you don't have like grave sins. And then you can go and you can have this peace and joy. It's spiritual food which will strengthen you on your way, on your spiritual way, as it did to me like yesterday. Yeah, it was yesterday actually. And so I wish you that you have the same experience of the power of the Holy Eucharist, and that you can receive this peace and joy which come when you have Jesus Christ inside of yourself, you know. And that's what I wish you, you know. And to my Protestant friends, I would want to say, you know, if this would only be a symbol, why would be all this followers of Christ would leave him, and only the 12 would have stayed? And Christ said, "Why you don't leave?" And they said, "No, where should we go? You are the source of life, you know. If it only would be a symbol, the people wouldn't have left. They wouldn't have said, well, now he's crazy, you know. What did they think? He's crazy. He's completely nuts now, saying you have to eat. This is my blood and this is my flesh. We are not, you know, we are not eating human flesh and blood, you know." That's what they thought. He's crazy. But they believed him, you know. They believed in the Son of God. And that's why you miss a lot when you're in the Protestant church. I wish you that you come back to the Catholic Church, to the fullness. We have the fullness in Christ. We have Christ in the Eucharist, you know. Look, the power of the Eucharist. So I wish you, you know, that you discover it as well. You know, I was a searcher as well, and I was against the Catholic Church. But when I experienced all these powerful tools like the confession and now the Eucharist, I only can say, wow, you missed something. And for the rest of you, for all of you, actually, all Christians, I wish you this, a joyful, a peaceful day. Always remember, we are the Hallelujah people. If you like this video, give me a like, share it to other people, subscribe to my channel, push the bell button, and you will receive the notification when there's new videos. You always can get my book. It's below this video. There is the link to it on Amazon. You will support my ministry by this. And I thank you very much. The book is called Thomas Huth, and the book is called Windsurfing with God, and you get like more details about this joyful way Christ offers us, you know. I wish you a wonderful and joyful day and evening, depending where you are, yeah? Have a good day. I love you. Have a good day, yeah? Ciao, or good evening. Ciao. I love you.